For me, I feel like when I take my daughter to the doctor, half the time I don't even know she's about to get a vaccine. We're just going because we have to. It's on the calendar. And even on the check-in paper, it says 15 minutes for, I guess that's how long the appointment is supposed to be. And I feel like I don't have enough time to ask information that I want to know.
They'll ask you if you have any more questions, but like, do they really mean it? Or is it just, like you said, a social cue, like, okay, we're wrapping up now, so.
So, thank you, bye.
Yeah.
Our primary job is to make sure that our patients get their questions answered. And yes, some patients come in with their list of questions, and I appreciate when they do that because, you know, that's the way they kind of organize their thoughts. But even if you don't go in with your list of questions, if there's something that you still feel wasn't answered fully or you still have a question on, don't be afraid to speak up. You know, that healthcare is not a privilege, it's a right.
And they start so young too with getting vaccines. Like, is this okay? Is this safe to get started on this path of getting all these vaccines? And then if I do decide to change my mind, can I? Will it be too late?
It's already stressful enough having to get, you know, my newborn in the car into the doctor's office for a checkup. And then they're like, oh, she needs 5 vaccines. And I'm like, excuse me.
They should have only the nutrients that they need. But then in one vaccine, they're getting, how much stuff are they getting in there at once? So I feel like that kind of doesn't make sense to me.
As a mother, like, you know, I completely understand why it's so, it could be devastating for a mom to see their little one kind of have to get all of those injections all at one time. But just like everything else, there is a reason for that. We know that there are certain times where a child may be more at risk to be infected by a certain virus. And so all the vaccines are designed to be given at a time where we kind of minimize that risk. It's also given at a time where we know that the immune system is going to be able to respond as effectively as it can. Having said that, however, if any mom had chosen to not vaccinate their kids, it is never too late to catch up. It may not be the schedule that we recommend because we're trying to minimize any risk to the child, but you can catch up on vaccines at any time. And you know, you could work with your doctor to figure out how you would do that. And so it's important to know that even though we're in much better shape, our survival rates for our children, thankfully, are much better than they were 30 years ago, 50 years ago. There's a reason for that, and we need to take the time to be able to explain to our parents and our patients what those reasons are so that then they can feel comfortable making an informed decision for their child.
Hearing all the different questions and hearing everyone's point of view on things, it just really open those doors. Like you said, just being able to talk to my children's doctor about it if I have any questions, feeling more confident in that.
Don't ever think that you're being a burden on a physician. If a physician is gonna look at it that way or see you that way, then maybe you shouldn't be seeing that physician. But I know that my colleagues and my peers welcome questions. And if we are in a tight spot, because we have to, you know, do something that's in a timely manner, we will always find a way to make sure that we follow up with that patient and get their questions answered. Thank you very much. I'm glad that you guys found this informative. I want to thank you guys for your vulnerability and thank you for that courage that you had and for trusting me to answer those questions.